Welcome to the FixSleep Bedtime Stories Channel, your sanctuary for relaxation, meditation, and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this journey to relaxation. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our magical sleep stories. So, let the tale begin. Circus Magic in the Sleeping City. Chapter 1. The Arrival of the Enchanted Circus. In the quiet town of Eldoria, nestled between rolling hills and whispering woods, life unfolded like the turning pages of a well-worn book. Routine was a trusted companion, and the townsfolk took solace in the familiar rhythm of their days. However, the arrival of the Enchanted Circus promised to rewrite the script of Eldoria's ordinary existence. As the first rays of the morning sun painted the cobblestone streets in hues of amber and gold, the distant sounds of wagon wheels creaking and animals chattering heralded the advent of the mystical caravan. Eldorians, roused from their peaceful slumber, peered through their curtains and stepped onto their doorsteps, their eyes widening with anticipation. The Enchanted Circus, with its kaleidoscopic tents and banners that fluttered like colorful butterflies, materialized on the outskirts of the town. Each tent bore the mark of time, embroidered with tales of performances witnessed across generations. The air crackled with an energy that felt like a promise, an unspoken vow that Eldoria's days of tranquility were about to be interrupted by an extraordinary spectacle. Children, their eyes sparkling with wonder, raced through the streets like playful spirits. The town's elders, with a glint of nostalgia in their eyes, reminisced about the last time the Enchanted Circus had graced Eldoria with its presence, decades ago. The younger generation, unaccustomed to such exhilarating events, found themselves caught between skepticism and excitement. As the first tent unfurled its majestic canvas, revealing an intricate tapestry of mythical creatures and mystical landscapes, the entire town seemed to hold its breath. The aroma of freshly popped corn and spun sugar wafted through the air, a sweet invitation to indulge in the forthcoming enchantment. Under the big top, a world of wonders awaited. The ringmaster, adorned in a coat of vibrant hues that mirrored the circus's vibrancy, stepped into the spotlight. With a voice that resonated like a melody, he welcomed the townsfolk to a realm where reality and fantasy danced together. Acrobats soared through the air, defying gravity with graceful flips and spins. Fire eaters painted the night with ephemeral hues, their flames dancing to a rhythm only they could hear. Tightrope walkers, suspended between the earth and the heavens, traced invisible paths with an elegance that left spectators breathless. In the heart of Eldoria, where quietude had long been the norm, applause erupted like a storm. The townspeople, united by the magic of the circus, found their voices in jubilation. Eldoria was no longer just a town. It had become a stage for the extraordinary. The clowns, with faces painted in hues brighter than a rainbow, emerged from the shadows, weaving humor into the fabric of reality. Their antics, a blend of slapstick and subtlety, transcended the boundaries of age, bringing laughter that echoed through the streets and lingered in the hearts of all who witnessed the spectacle. As the night unfolded, the enchanted circus painted a dreamscape under the star-studded canvas of the sky. The moon, a silent witness to the marvels below, bathed the town in a silver glow. Eldoria, once a realm of predictable routine, had become a tapestry woven with threads of fantasy and delight. In the afterglow of the circus's debut performance, the townspeople, now filled with a renewed sense of awe, returned to their homes. The once ordinary town had been touched by the wand of enchantment, and Eldoria, the slumbering beauty, had awakened to a new chapter one, written in the magical ink of the enchanted circus. Chapter 2, Markets of Wonders and Sweets. The following day in Eldoria dawned with a palpable sense of anticipation. The air hummed with a lingering enchantment, and the townspeople, their dreams woven with the threads of circus magic, eagerly made their way to the heart of the spectacle, the markets of wonders and sweets. The marketplace, usually a space for mundane transactions and practical exchanges, underwent a breathtaking metamorphosis. Stalls adorned with trinkets and souvenirs stood like sentinels, each item a portal to the fantastical world created by the circus. The aroma of freshly baked pastries mingled with the sweet scent of cotton candy, creating a symphony of delightful fragrances that hung in the air. Families strolled through the marketplace, children clutching their parents' hands with wide-eyed wonder. The stalls beckoned with a promise of treasures that mirrored the enchanting performances witnessed the night before. Colorful masks, miniature replicas of circus tents, and handcrafted figurines of acrobats poised mid-flight adorned the shelves, each telling a story of the magical evening that had unfolded under the big top. The sweet stalls, awash with hues of spun sugar and confectionery delights, became a haven for those with a sweet tooth. Candied apples sparkled like jewels, their glossy exteriors reflecting the sunlight. Jars filled with rainbow-hued lollipops and jars of glistening caramel promised a taste of the circus's sugary magic. Among the bustling market activity, a small stage was erected, and a group of musicians tuned their instruments. The lively tunes that emanated from their strings and drums added a festive rhythm to the ambience. Folk dances spontaneously broke out, with townspeople twirling and clapping in joyful unison. Eldoria, once known for its serene pace, now pulsed with an infectious vibrancy. In a corner of the market, a storyteller unfolded tales of circuses long past, captivating an eager audience. The tales were like bridges between generations, connecting the nostalgia of the elders with the wide-eyed curiosity of the younger folk. The stories painted pictures of daring feats, magical creatures, and the timeless allure of the circus. As the day unfolded, the markets became not just a place of commerce, but a communal celebration. Faces lit up with joy as children indulged in sticky sweet treats, their laughter becoming a melody that underscored the vivacious energy of the enchanted circus. At the heart of the marketplace, a grand puppeteer set up his stage. His marionettes, intricately carved and painted, came to life with each pull of the strings. The puppeteer skillfully wove a narrative, creating characters that mirrored the whimsical performers of the circus. The audience, captivated by the the mesmerizing dance of the marionettes, found themselves transported into a miniature world of enchantment. Eldoria, once a haven of quietude, had become a vibrant tapestry of color, laughter, and shared joy. The markets of wonders and sweets, an unexpected chapter in the town's history, had turned into a communal celebration, a testament to the transformative power of the enchanted circus. As the townspeople dispersed, carrying with them memories wrapped in the vibrant hues of the marketplace, Eldoria settled into a night adorned with the echo of laughter and the soft glow of lanterns. The magic of the circus had not only touched the hearts of the townspeople, but had become an inseparable part of their collective story, etched into the very fabric of their lives. Chapter 3: Enchanted Beasts in the Town Park. The day following the enchanting marketplace experience in Eldoria dawned with a sense of heightened curiosity. The townspeople, still entranced by the lingering magic of the circus, gathered in eager anticipation at the town park, where the next act of this extraordinary spectacle was about to unfold: the arrival of the enchanted beasts. The sun cast its gentle rays upon the lush greenery of the park, where the towering oaks and fragrant blossoms formed a natural tapestry. A hush fell over the assembled crowd as a procession of wagons, adorned with fantastical imagery and accompanied by ethereal music, made its way toward the park's entrance. The townspeople, their eyes reflecting a mix of awe and reverence, watched as the wagons came to a graceful stop. The circus handlers, dressed in garments reminiscent of medieval storytellers, began to unveil the magical creatures within. Majestic unicorns, their coats shimmering like liquid silver, stepped into the daylight, their hooves barely touching the ground. Exotic birds with plumage and hues, unseen in the ordinary realm, perched on gilded stands, their melodies adding a symphony of natural magic to the air. The pièce de résistance emerged from the largest wagon, a mythical creature known as a moonlight drake, with scales that glittered like the night sky. Its wings unfurled, creating an ethereal spectacle that mirrored the stars. Gasps of amazement and whispered awe swept through the crowd like a gentle breeze. Children, their eyes wide with wonder, tentatively approached the enchanted creatures under the watchful eyes of their parents. Eldorians, who had once only dreamed of such fantastical beings, found themselves standing in the presence of living legends. The connection between the townspeople and the enchanted beasts transcended the ordinary. It was as if the creatures themselves recognized the open hearts before them. The park, once a serene retreat, transformed into a magical menagerie where the barriers between reality and fantasy blurred. The unicorns grazed gracefully, their eyes reflecting ancient wisdom, while the exotic birds added a vibrant symphony to the rustling leaves. The moonlight drake, regal and otherworldly, captivated the onlookers with its majestic presence. As the day unfolded, the circus handlers invited the townspeople to partake in activities that fostered a deeper connection with the enchanted creatures. Children brushed the manes of unicorns, their laughter harmonizing with the gentle neighs of the mythical steeds. Elders shared whispered conversations with the exotic birds, as if unraveling the secrets of the ages through their colorful plumage. In a secluded area of the park, The moonlight drake's presence cast a luminous glow, inviting those brave enough to approach. The creature, though magnificent, exuded a calm and benevolent energy, as if acknowledging the shared enchantment between itself and the townspeople. The park, now a living canvas painted with the magic of the circus, became a space of shared wonder and unity. Families picnicked beneath the shade of ancient trees, their laughter blending with the harmonious sounds of the enchanted beasts. The once slumbering town of Eldoria had awakened to a new reality, one where the fantastical and the everyday coexisted in perfect harmony. The circus handlers helped the enchanted animals back into their wagons as the sun descended, bathing the area in a warm, golden glow. The villagers remained in the last of the light, not wanting to see the magical beings go. With a flutter of wings and a nod of royalty, the creatures bid their newfound pals farewell. Eldoria, now forever marked by the imprint of the enchanted circus, held the memories of the day in its heart. The park, once a sanctuary of stillness, had become a living testament to the transformative power of magic, a power that connected the townspeople to a realm where the ordinary met the extraordinary. As the last echoes of footsteps faded away, the park retained a shimmering glow, a testament to the enchanted chapter that had unfolded under the watchful eyes of mythical beings. Chapter 4, A Dazzling Farewell Celebration. As the sun dipped below the horizon, casting a warm, golden glow across Eldoria, the townspeople found themselves reluctantly bidding farewell to the enchanting beings that had graced their park. The air was imbued with a bittersweet emotion, a sense of gratitude for the magical moments shared, yet an acknowledgement of the fleeting nature of the extraordinary. The circus handlers, with a profound understanding of the delicate balance between worlds, guided the enchanted creatures back into their opulent wagons. The moonlight drake, with its wings folded gracefully, cast a final, radiant gaze upon the assembled crowd. The unicorns, dignified and wise, trotted with an otherworldly grace. The exotic birds, their melodies still lingering in the air, perched regally on their gilded stands. As the last wagon disappeared from view, a collective sigh swept through the park. Eldorians, their hearts now intertwined with the magic of the circus, stood in quiet contemplation. The park, once pulsating with the vibrant energy of enchanted beings, now echoed with the fading whispers of a realm that had briefly intersected with their own. Yet, the circus was not ready to bid Eldoria adieu without one final, dazzling spectacle, a farewell celebration that would etch itself into the collective memory of the town. The air crackled with anticipation as townspeople gathered in the central square, where the circus had first unfolded its tapestry of wonders. The ringmaster, resplendent in his vibrant attire, emerged onto a makeshift stage. His presence alone seemed to awaken a dormant energy in the square. The townspeople, their faces illuminated by the soft glow of lanterns and the fading sunlight, turned their attention to the central figure, the orchestrator of their magical journey. With a sweep of his hand, the ringmaster signaled to the musicians, who began to play a melody that mirrored the ebb and flow of emotions in the square. A gentle waltz, infused with both melancholy and celebration, became the soundtrack to Eldoria's farewell to the circus. Dancers, adorned in costumes reminiscent of the enchanted creatures, twirled and swayed in perfect harmony with the music. Their movements, a delicate balance between joy and sorrow, mirrored the collective sentiment of the townspeople. Eldoria, now a town forever changed, danced through the night with the echoes of the circus still reverberating in its heart. Amidst the revelry, the clowns emerged, their faces painted with both laughter and tears. With exaggerated gestures and playful antics, they invited the townspeople to join in their merriment. The square, once a stage for ordinary events, became a canvas for the whimsical performance that unfolded under the twilight sky. A procession of lanterns, held by children and adults alike, wound its way through the square. Each lantern, a symbol of the collective light that the circus had ignited in Eldoria, cast a warm glow on the faces of those who bore them. As the night deepened, the ringmaster stepped forward once more, his gaze a reflection of the countless tales he had witnessed unfold in Eldoria. With eloquence and a touch of theatrical flair, he expressed gratitude for the town's warm embrace. His words, a poetic farewell, resonated with the townspeople, creating a bridge between the fantastical world of the circus and the everyday reality of Eldoria. The farewell celebration's grand finale began with an amazing fireworks show that illuminated the night sky in a rainbow of hues, like fleeting flowers. The fireworks bestowed one last spell of enchantment onto Eldoria before vanishing into the night. As the last echo of the fireworks faded away, the ringmaster took a bow, and the square fell into a hushed silence. The townspeople, their hearts full, and their eyes shimmering with the residue of magic, stood united in a moment of shared reflection. Eldoria, now draped in the gentle cloak of night, held the lingering warmth of the enchanted circus in its embrace. The square, once a stage for the extraordinary, returned to a semblance of quietude. Yet the echoes of laughter, music, and the farewell celebration lingered in the air. The townspeople, with a mixture of nostalgia and contentment, dispersed into the night. Eldoria, forever marked by the enchanting chapter it had hosted, settled into a serene slumber. The enchanted circus, having woven itself into the very fabric of the town's history, departed with the promise that its magic would be whispered in the wind, echoed in the laughter of children, and imprinted in the collective dreams of Eldoria for generations to come.